In this video, we are going to study about when a rectangular loop, a rectangular circuit is moving in a magnetic field and the magnetic field is non-uniform and this coil is moving with a constant velocity v. So we can name this as rectangular loop moving with constant velocity in non-uniform magnetic field. So the magnetic field is not uniform. On one side we have B1 magnetic field. So let us say that ABCD is a rectangular coil, then side AB will be in B1 magnetic field and side CD is in B2 magnetic field. And let us say that B1 is greater than B2, the magnetic field strength of B1 is greater than the field of B2. And the rectangular loop is moving in this direction with constant velocity. That means it is going from high magnetic field, high strength magnetic field, towards low strength magnetic field. So what will be the change, what will be the induced EMF or induced current in such case? Now when the coil is moving, it will cut the magnetic field lines. While moving these magnetic field lines, these are represented by dots. Dots mean that the direction of magnetic field is perpendicularly outward. It is coming out of the pole. So when this coil is moving like this, it will cut all the magnetic field lines. It is moving with some velocity, so it will cut the magnetic field lines at some rate, and that rate will give us the induced EMF, because we know whenever a circular coil whenever a coil or a loop is cutting magnetic field lines, there will be induced EMF. Now if we, let us say that distance traveled in time delta t, let us say that after a small time delta t, this loop has shifted this way. So we can say that this side AB will come here and this side CD will be here. The loop has shifted, and let us say that it took a time delta t to shift. So what will be the length? Length is the distance traveled. Distance traveled is velocity into time. Velocity is v. Time taken is delta t. So that means this distance traveled is v delta t. The distance traveled in time delta t is v delta t. Now there is, when the coil shifted at distance with distance v delta t, it covered some area, and whatever magnetic field lines were in that area, this particular area cut those magnetic field lines. So this area is a rectangle. We can say that it has shifted by this particular area. So if this is the breadth and this is length, then the total this area that is cut by the loop will be length into v delta t. So we can say area traveled is equal to length into v delta t. This will be your area, and in this area whatever magnetic field lines were there, those magnetic field lines were cut by the conductor AB, and similarly here also same area was cut. So that means there will be some change in flux, or there will be some flux on this side also and on this side also. The flux is B into A. So for phi B1, the total flux will be B1 into delta A, the change in area, and B1 change in area is LV delta T. So this will be the flux at B1. Similarly, flux at B2 will be B2 LV delta T. What is the change in flux when the loop shifted? Let us say that the change in flux is delta phi B. So this will be equal to phi B2 minus phi B1. So LV delta T will be common, and it will be B2 minus B1. Now, so this is the rate, this is the change in flux. If we bring this delta T here in the denominator, this will be equal to LV B2 minus B1. Now, what is delta phi B upon delta T? This is a rate of change of flux. And according to Faraday and Lenz law, the induced EMF epsilon is given as d phi b by dt. So that means This is d5 by dt. If we put the value, then it will be minus LV B2 minus B1. Or if we bring this minus sign into the bracket, then induced EMF will be equals to LV B1 minus B2. So this will be the value of induced EMF. Now if we consider, say, let us say that the loop has resistance R. So I'll write it here. If the loop has resistance R, then the current that will be induced will be equal to EMF upon R. So it will be equal to LV by R into B1 minus B2. So this will be the induced values of induced EMF and induced current when the loop is moving with a constant velocity in a varying magnetic field, in a non-uniform magnetic field. Now, because of the non-uniformity and because of the motion, there will be some forces that will be experienced by these conductors. Now, you can use Fleming's right hand rule, and you can find the forces. Now, if we see the direction of BC, BC will not cut any magnetic field lines because it is not perpendicular like this, it is moving like this. So it will pass through the magnetic field line, it will not cut any. So whatever small force will be there, that force will be in upward, and on this side it will be downward direction, and it will be same force from here at every point. If we see, let us say that B1 is greater, so there will be greater force, but the similar force will be in downward direction also. And because B2 is weaker magnetic field, there will be weak force, but it will also be balanced by this force. So all the strong and weak forces in upward direction will be balanced by the strong and weak, corresponding strong and weak forces in the downward direction. So BC and AD will not experience any net force. But AB side and CD side, now here from Fleming's right hand rule, you will find out that there will be a force in this direction, let us say F1, and here there will be a force in this direction, which will be F2. Now since B1 is greater than B2, this side is completely in B1, this side is completely in B2, that means the force that is applied on AB, which is F1, it will be greater than F2. These forces will not balance because these sides are completely in two different strength of magnetic field. So there will be difference in forces, and F1 will be greater than F2. That means when we are moving this coil in this direction, we have to do some work. Because of this work, there will be an energy which will be stored in the coil, and that energy might be released when the current is flowing. That energy will be released in the form of heat or light, mostly in the form of heat. And second thing that is important to understand here is what will be the direction of current. Will the direction of current be ABCD or will it be ADCD? So this also, if you refer to one of the older videos in which there was a rod AB which was moved in a magnetic field, and there were current induced in that video, we studied about what are the direction of flow of electron and direction of flow of current. So same concept, you watch that video again if you are not able to understand, and same concept can be applied here, and you can find whether the current will be in clockwise direction or anti-clockwise direction. So that is an exercise for you to find if the current is moving from ABCDA or ADCBA, clockwise or anti-clockwise direction.